Hey, fourth grade ELA. Just don't worry about a thing, you guys. Everything's going to be all right. Just keep telling yourself that. So here we are. I'm going to do a lunch money book study with you, a chapter a day. If you want to do more, you can, but I'd like you just to do a chapter a day at your own time when it's easy for you to get on the computer. So I'm going to be switching back and forth from reading to my computer so I can make sure I get everything to you that I want you to have for this lesson. So you'll need your lunch money book. Your parent was supposed to have picked that up on the 7th. So hopefully you have that. This book has to come back to the school. So please, please, please be careful with it. Don't let your siblings play with it. Don't let the dog chew on it. Don't let your little brother or sister color on it. Don't let mom or dad use it for toilet paper. Please, Pinky, promise me it'll come back to the school. Pinky, there we go. Thank you. So with that, I want you to have your book out, and I want you to have a notebook or a piece of paper and something to write with. You know I prefer a pencil. However, if you want to use a pen or a marker, that's fine. I'm not going to fuss at you. I can't fuss at you, so you can use whatever you want. So first thing I want you to do on your paper is to write down the word sell. And that's the word sell with an S, not a C. Okay, S-E-L-L. So if you had the base word sell and you added an E-R at the end, okay, add two letters to the end, E-R, what do we have as our new word? Seller, okay? Now I want you to write the base word sell again. And I want you to put ing at the end. Now, what word do you have? Yes, selling. Now, I want you to write the base word sell again. And I want you to put A-B-L-E at the end. What do you have? Sellable. Let's read them together. Seller, selling, sellable. What do you call those letters that we put at the end of the base word? Yes, suffix. What do you call the letters we put at the beginning of a word to make a new meaning? Prefix. Excellent. Pre, beginning, suffix, end. And what's the A word if it's a prefix or a suffix? Affix. Exactly. Good job remembering. Yay. So if we have someone who, we have a seller, we have someone who sells something. Selling is something you're doing right now. What part of speech is a word that you're doing it right now? It's a what? Yes, it's a verb. And then if something is sellable, that means someone wants it and you can sell it to them. Just like if we had, you don't have to write these, but if we had invest as the base word, okay, and we put O-R at the end, invest or, okay, that would be someone who invests something, money usually, right? Or what if we had invest as the base word or the root word, and we put re at the beginning as your prefix? Reinvest, it would mean to invest again. Okay, I just want to go over that with you to make sure you're remembering. We're going to read Lunch Money, and it's about a boy named Greg and his plan to make money, okay, hence the title Lunch Money. We want to talk about character, plot, and setting, and as I read the first paragraph with you, I want you to determine if it's first person or third person, and you know how to do that, okay? And I say we get started, okay? So Lunch Money by Andrew Clements. Chapter one is called Talent, and yes, I know they didn't indent the first paragraph. I hate it when they do that. Greg Kenton had heaps of talent. He was good at baseball and even better at soccer. He had a clear singing voice and he also played the piano. He was a whiz at sketching and drawing, and he did well at school. Reading, science, music, writing, art, math, gym, social studies, the whole deal. But as good as he was at all these things, Greg's greatest talent had always been money. Okay, let's stop there and let's talk about which person point of view it is. So it starts with saying Greg Kenton, and it uses the pronoun he. Uh-huh. So could it be first person? No. So what do you guys think it is? Exactly, third person, because they're replacing Greg Kenton with he. Okay, if it was first person, what would the pronoun be again? Yep, I. Excellent. I want you to also write down a talent that you have. Okay, so you wrote down the point of view, you wrote third person, and then I want you to write down a talent that you have. Okay, if you need to hit pause, you can. So let's continue on with paragraph two. Greg had never taken money lessons. He hadn't had a money tutor or gone money to money camp. His talent with money was natural. He had always understood money. He knew how to save it, how to keep track of it, how to grow it, and most of all, how to make it. It takes some kids years and years to figure out that everything is worth something. Not Greg. Sitting in a grocery cart by the door of the supermarket, he had watched with sharp brown eyes, top of the next page, as his mom dropped a small metal disc into a red machine. Then she turned the crank, and a handful of M&Ms had rattled out into her hand. Greg loved the sweet, crunchy taste. Sweet, crunchy, what are those? What part of speech? Describing words? Yes, adjective. But it wasn't the candy that had captured his imagination. It was the shiny silver coin. While he was still a skinny preschooler with curly brown hair, Greg had learned to keep his eyes and ears open. One day at breakfast, his biggest brother, Ross, griped, "How come I have to make my bed? I'm just going to mess it up again tonight." His older big brother, Edward, chimed in, "And cleaning up our rooms every single morning? That's not fair. Besides, they're our rooms." His mom had answered, "Yes, but your rooms are in my house, and I like my house tidy. So if you want to keep getting your allowances every Friday, get back upstairs and fix the mess." Okay, notice the quotation marks. Okay, we call that dialogue, right? The discussion that's going on between the brothers and the mom. Notice the commas after the beginning of the sentence where it says besides, comma, okay, introductions. Last paragraph, Ross and Edward had grumbled all the way back to their rooms. Their little brother followed them, and 2 minutes later, Greg had started a housekeeping business. Making a bed, 10 cents. Putting dirty clothes in the laundry, 5 cents. Putting clean clothes away, 2 cents. And hanging up used towels, 3 cents each. If both his big brothers were complete slobs, and they usually were, Greg earned a little more than $2 a week, so it was certainly not a get-rich-quick scheme. But that wasn't what Greg was trying to do. He was perfectly happy to get rich slowly, because being patient is a big part of having money talent. Greg understood that a year has 52 weeks. So between the ages of 4 and 6, Greg transformed rumpled sheets, used underwear, ew, smelly socks, gross, and soggy towels into beautiful, spendable cash. More than $200. Well, that's pretty darn good. Then his mom shut down his business, insisting that Ross and Edward had to do their own chores. I kind of agree. When he was still in nursery school, Greg had taken charge of recycling the family's trash. He emptied all the waste baskets at least once a week. At the bins out in the garage, he sorted the newspapers and magazines from the cardboard and the aluminum from the steel and the number one plastic from the number two plastic. Now, you should pause in just a second and go look in your pantry. I grabbed a couple things to see what the numbers were on the back. So here I've got some oil here, and I looked at the bottom. That's recycle number one. And then I was just eating peanut butter because I love me some peanut butter. And that had a 5. I don't know if you can see it on it. So, I don't know, that's kind of fun, and you can look up online and see what all the little codes mean. It's a different way of sorting it, so it's pretty interesting. Let's continue. As a reward for his service, which only took him 10 minutes a week, Greg was allowed to keep the deposit refunds on all the cans and bottles. This added up to about $4 a month in the cool seasons and $8 a month during the long, thirsty summer. As a 7- and 8-year-old, Greg had found other ways to make money around the house and yard. He shined his dad's and mom's dress shoes for 50 cents a pair. He scrubbed black heel marks and old wax off the floor tiles in the kitchen for 10 cents a square. He dug dandelions out of the lawn at the rate of 4 for a nickel, and he picked Japanese beetles off the shrubs for a penny a bug. At first, Greg enjoyed simply having the money he made. Cash was fun and interesting all by itself. He liked sorting and stacking the bills, singles, 5s, 10s, 20s, and even a few 50s he'd gotten from his grandparents for Christmas. You gotta love those grandparents. He studied the faces of the famous presidents, and Alexander Hamilton, too, who he discovered was never a president, only the first secretary of the Treasury of the United States. He looked at the engraving on the bills with a magnifying glass, studying the tiny face of Lincoln sitting there on his big square chair inside the Lincoln Memorial on the back of every $5 bill. Greg found the coins just as interesting. He loved making rolls of quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies, stacks and stacks of them. And the golden Sacagawea dollar coins? Do you guys have any of those? I have a couple. I don't know where they are, but they're super cool. He didn't put them into rolls. He had collected 27 of them, which he had hidden in a sock in the bottom drawer of his dresser. Every once in a while, he'd spread them out on his bed and count them again. Greg also became an amateur coin collector. Do you know what amateur means? Yeah, someone who's like doesn't get paid for what they do. So like maybe I'm a professional teacher, I get paid for teaching. Your parents are amateur teachers, they don't get paid, although they're definitely earning their money right now. They're not getting paid for teaching you. So I'm trying to help them out with this video. All right, page 6. It was exciting to come up with the Mercury dime now and then, and he'd found a couple dozen of those gray pennies that had been made out of steel instead of copper during the Second World War. Now, that was a long time ago. I don't have any of those, but that would be cool. He had found pennies that were worth $10 or more, and that can get a kid thinking. As nice as it was to have money itself, Greg quickly learned it was also fun to spend some now and then. He would spend it for something special, like his own professional quality soccer ball, or one of those huge aluminum flashlights with 6 batteries that could throw a beam of light all the way across the lake at his grandpa's cabin. He bought cool stuff he really wanted, and mostly when it seemed too long a wait until his birthday or Christmas. He bought a collectible baseball cards, and he had also bought a few Beanie Babies and sold them for a nice profit. Beanie Babies are those little stuffed animals, and my daughter used to have a ton of them. Sometimes he bought comic books, but only a few and only ones that looked like they would become more valuable. Greg loved comics, but he got to read all he wanted for free because his dad collected them. You should ask your parents if they collect anything. I mostly just collect like bears and stuff. I like bears, but I don't really collect anything anymore. By the time he got to third grade, Greg had set himself a goal. He wanted to be rich. He thought it would be fantastic to be able to spend all the money he wanted anytime he felt like it. If he wanted to get the world's fastest computer plus 100 of the best games, no problem. If he wanted a car, a speedboat, a house in the mountains, a home theater system, or even a whole island out in the middle of the Pacific, plus his own seaplane and a private crew to fly him there, no problem. Greg was sure that someday he'd be able to get anything he wanted, and all he'd need was money. Okay, I want you to do a free write for 3 minutes. You're going to have to hit pause on this in a second because I don't know how to stop it and restart it. So I want you to hit pause in just a second. I want you to do a free write. And I want you to start writing about if you had all the money in the world, what would you buy and what would you do with it? Okay, for instance, I might buy a big, huge yacht and hire somebody to make us all the pizzas and ice cream sundaes and brownies and milkshakes and everything we wanted, all of us. So you think about it, and I want you to do 3 minutes. I can't time you, so you just time yourself or have someone time you and just write for 3 minutes about what you would do if you had all the money in the world. You could have anything you want, and come right back to me. Okay, good job. Next paragraph. And he wasn't that different from his friends. A lot of them also dreamed about getting rich, and some of them wanted to be famous, too. Greg didn't care much about fame. What was the point? Besides, he figured that if he got rich enough, really super rich, then the famous part would happen automatically. Anyway. But there was one big difference between Greg and most of his friends. He wasn't just dreaming about getting rich. He was working on it. As Greg reached third grade and then fourth, his whole neighborhood had become, top of page 8, the land of opportunity. He was thin, but wiry, and strong enough to tackle any job he put his mind to. Greg raked and bagged leaves in the fall and again in the spring. He washed cars all spring, summer, and fall, and on hot days he sold lemonade. He shoveled snow and salted icy sidewalks in the winter. Greg became a feeder of cats, a walker of dogs, and a collector of mail and newspapers for people on vacation. He swept garages and straightened up messy basements. If people ever decided to throw things away, Greg kept the good stuff for himself and hauled it home to his own little corner of the Kenton family garage. And when he had collected enough interesting junk, Greg would drag it all out to the end of the driveway, put up a sign, and hold a sale. Neighborhood money filled Greg's pockets the way rain fills puddles. For example, consider what Greg earned just from shoveling snow. He had 8 customers within 2 blocks of his house, and every time it snowed, he shoveled the front walks for flat rate, $10. The winter of his third grade year, it snowed 6 times. And the winter of his fourth grade year, it snowed 5 times. And 11 snowfalls times 8 customers equals 88 shovel sessions times $10 for each one equals $880, which isn't just a lot of money to a 9-year-old. $880 is a lot of money to anybody. It hadn't taken Greg long to become the family banker. If his mom and dad were running late for a movie on the Saturday night, Greg was happy to lend them $20 as long as they signed his little record book and promised to repay the money. And his parents got special treatment. They didn't have to pay Greg's usual lending fees. After all, they didn't charge him for the food he ate every night or for the safe warm bed he slept in every night. So that seemed fair, but his two brothers had to pay the regular rates. If his older brother needed an extra $5 to get the new baseball glove in time to break it in before the Babe Ruth tryouts, Greg was happy to lend him the money, as long as Edward signed the book and promised to pay back the $5 one week later, plus a 50-cent fee, and Greg got the old mitt as part of the deal, because a used baseball glove might be worth something at his next driveway sale. And if Frost just had to have that hot new CD the instant it arrived in the music store, he knew his little brother would be happy to help. For a fee. Both Ross and Edward made fun of Greg's money-making schemes. They called him Scrooge and Mr. Cashman and Old Moneybags and some other nicknames, too. Still, whenever they needed money, they knew who would always be welcome. They would always be welcome at the First Family Bank of Greg. One Thursday, shortly after Greg had finished fourth grade, his dad pulled a reference book off the shelf next to the computer in the family room. Along with the information he'd been looking for, he also found 12 $5 bills tucked between the pages. Only one person in the family could have owned that money. So at bedtime that night, he told Greg that he'd found it. Greg sat straight up in bed. "You put it all away back, right?" His dad said, "Absolutely. But how about we go to the bank on Saturday morning and open up a savings account?" Do you guys have a savings account? Or you keep your money that you make? You should, because it earns interest in that, and we'll talk about that in a second. "That's where your money belongs." Greg had looked at him suspiciously. "Why?" "Because your money will be safe at the bank, and it'll be there when you need it, like when you go to college. So you guys can save money in there, and then you'll have it when you go off to college or you need to buy a car." Greg said, "But can I get my money out before then? Like if I see something I need at a yard sale?" Well, his dad nodded. "You're allowed to get your money anytime you want. But if you take the money out of the bank, then the money won't grow." "Grow?" said Greg. "You mean earn interest, right?" A little surprised, his dad had nodded and said, "Right, earn interest. If you put $100 in the bank and leave it there for 1 year, the bank will add $5 more to it. And then you'll have $105. That's called earning 5% interest a year. And all the money has to do is sit there." "Pretty neat, huh?" Greg thought about that. "So my money just sits there?" His dad said, "Well, actually, this is the complicated part. The bank will probably lend your money to other people. And top of page 12, then those other people will pay the bank interest for being able to use it. Just like the bank pays you that $5 of interest so that you can use your money. They can use your money." Greg said, "And if I only get $5, if I let the bank use my $100 for a whole year, that stinks. Because if I spend $2 on lemon juice and sugar and paper cups, and if I sell 30 cups of lemonade this weekend, then in 1 weekend I'll make more money than the bank would pay me all year." That's true," his dad said. "Making your own business investments is a way to earn more money faster, as long as you make good investments. But if you keep hiding your money around the house, it could get lost or stolen." "But what about your comic books?" Greg asked. "You keep the whole collection right here in the house." His dad nodded. "True, but I've got an insurance policy on them and a special policy on the most valuable ones. And if something happened to my comics, the insurance company would pay me back the money they're worth. But you can't get an insurance policy on money itself unless you keep it in a bank. So if a house burned down, you'd have no money at all. None, and you'd get nothing back." Oh, that got Greg's attention. The next day, Greg had retrieved money from about 30 different hiding places around the house and yard and garage. And on Saturday morning, he'd gone to the bank and opened his own savings account with a first deposit that amazed his dad. Get this, you guys, more than $3,200. And that wasn't even all of Greg's money, just most of it. He'd kept a couple $100 at home because Greg already understood that sometimes a business person needs money right away.
By age 11, he was well on his way to success, always on the lookout for new money-making opportunities. And then one day, Greg Kenton made the greatest financial discovery of his young life. Okay, here's what I want you to do. Yeah, you know what I'm going to have you do, write a summary. So just a paragraph, I want you to indent. I want you to have capitals, periods, correct punctuation, spelling, the whole deal. And I want you to write a summary telling me what just happened in this chapter. Okay, 3 to 5 sentences. Start at the beginning, the middle, and the end. Just who he was, what he did. Tell me about his brothers, the kind of business he had with his siblings. And then that he opened up his account. And then end it. And then we will continue on tomorrow. If you come back tomorrow or your next opportunity, we will do chapter 2. Okay, have a great day. I love you guys. Bye.